hosts Cecil Chandler and Amanda Sellers. If it's happening in the area, it's on Carolina & Company Live.
All right, we are back. Welcome to Carolina & Company Live. Been off the air for about a week for our show.
I didn't see it. But I do want to say one thing. Let me tell you, the news coverage that we did, our meteorologists, our news people, they really covered the storm to keep you informed. And that's what it's all about. Let me say, it was a great job.
Yeah, they actually absolutely knocked it out of the park, making sure you guys were safe. But we are happy to be back, and we do have a great show lined up for your Monday. Right there it is. Of course, our Hollywood Minute. We roll right into our video of the day, and then
celebrity birthdays. Your celebrity could be having a birthday today. And also, today's show, we're going to be talking about a cancer fundraiser at the Beaver Bar.
That's right.
And we're also talking about the Buddy Walk that's coming up. We'll tell you that and a lot more.
That's right. Talking about Caring in Our Lifetime and their Breast Friends Forever fundraiser coming up to October, being Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Also, of course, Kindkeeper is here needing lots of help, lots of donations after the hurricane. And also, we're looking for a foster dog who has gotten out, and we need your help finding him. All that and more coming up right after your Hollywood Minute.
Miley Cyrus sings about giving up the party scene and apparently her breakup with Liam Hemsworth in her new video for Slide Away. Miley commented on Twitter recently, "I had to make a healthy decision for myself to leave a previous life behind."
When I was a kid, there was a place. A dark place. They closed it down and let it rot. But the things that live there. They come back.
The Overlook Hotel still stands, and Danny Torrance is all grown up in the final trailer for Dr. Sleep, based on Stephen King's sequel to The Shining. Ewan McGregor, Kylie Curran, and Rachel Ferguson star in the final trailer for the horror flick, which arrives in theaters November 8th.
Everyone knows these stories.
Hayley Atwell's had plenty of missions as Peggy Carter in the Marvel Universe, but her next one may be impossible. According to The Hollywood Reporter, the British actress is joining the cast of the next Mission Impossible movie, the seventh in the series. No title yet, but they have time. The film's not due out until July of 2021. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
All right, talking about a teacher's post that went viral, the University of Tennessee. It looks like the child was bullied for a homemade t-shirt, but guess what? Those kids get the last laugh. In a Facebook post, the boy's teacher said he went to represent the University of Tennessee and during his school's college color day, but he didn't have anything official. So guess what? He drew up one, and some of his classmates reportedly laughed at him.
Well, the teacher's post went viral. The university made an exact replica of the Florida boy's hand-sketched design and turned it into their official apparel. Money raised from each shirt sold will be donated to the organization Stomp Out Bullying. How about that?
That is awesome.
That is so cool.
That's really cool. And a cool t-shirt, too. I hope everybody goes out
really
and gets
do.
That one.
All right, we got a special birthday today. Let's talk about it. Let me show you. There she is, Karen. Karen Breen's birthday yesterday, so we didn't get a chance to tell her that, so we want to say happy birthday today. And she was her own present. She came wrapped in that box.
And didn't somebody else special had a birthday, didn't they?
Who, me?
Yesterday. Whose birthday was yesterday?
I have no idea.
Jeff's?
Oh, my son's birthday. I'm sorry, Jeff Chandler. Boy, I'm really losing it. That's right, he turned 40 yesterday.
Right,
it's been a long time since we've been on the air. All right, today's Monday, September 9th, and this is National Teddy Bear Day.
And this is also Do Opposite Day. Well, there you go, right there.
That's right. What we normally do. Birthdays today, let's check it out. 1960, there he is, Hugh Grant, 59 years old, films Notting Hill and Mickey Blue Eyes. And he considered a career as an art historian before he became an actor.
He did pretty well as an actor. 1971, Eric Stone Street, 48 years old. TV's Modern Family and appearances also on CSI. Ooh, the next one. Can I do the next one?
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead.
1975, Michael Bublé. He is 44 years old, Grammy Award-winning jazz singer, sold over 50 million records. He is incredible.
You like him. You like him.
Well, yeah. No, I just think he's got an incredible voice.
Oh,
I don't care for him.
Well, The next guy had an incredible voice, too. Let's look at today in history. 1956, Elvis Presley made his first appearance on The Ed Sullivan Show, Toast of the Town. Now, listen to this. He wiggled so much, they shot him from just the waist up during the performance. And Elvis would make a total of 3 appearances on the show. Later, they filmed him why. So, you know, just look at some of the entertainers today. I don't even know how they film them, period.
All right, 1986. Ooh, that was the year I was born. Ted Turner presented the first of his colorized films on WTBS in Atlanta, Georgia.
That's right, and there's some great ones on there, too. From the Know-It-All Department today, here we go where you learn something. People are always praying for, you know, what you would expect, not all the time praying for what they expect. Here it is. According to a 2014 survey by a Christian retailer, Lifeway in Nashville, listen to this, 7% of Christian Americans pray for a parking spot.
Guilty as charged.
You pray for a parking spot too?
Absolutely. Every single time. Guess what?
So you don't always pray for what you know, you don't always get what you pray for in that, I don't
believe. But guess what?
What's that?
I always get to park, so.
You do?
Guess it works, right?
Oh. That's it from a Know-It-All Department today. A great time to have you back, and it's good to be back on the air.
That's
and we're
right.
Going to talk a little about, we're going to introduce this now. Rossi, what's that?
Yeah, that's right. Looking for a go-to shoe? Well, that's stylish and comfortable. These things are amazing. Amazing here with some of the top picks from Rothy's.
It's no secret, I love Rothy's. I ordered a pair online this year. Now I'm hooked. I wear them to work, even to the playground with the kids. The shoes are made with repurposed water bottles, ready to wear right out of the box, zero break-in period. Plus, they're machine washable. Love that. So here's my picks every woman needs in her closet. The point, flat, loafer, and sneaker. All iconic styles reinvented. So this is the black point. It's classic, versatile, bestseller, Meghan Markle was spotted wearing this exact style, so you'll feel like royalty. The round toe black flat is a classic, goes with everything, and when you're feeling a little wild, there are endless colors and patterns to play with, like the cool spotted flat with a red heel stripe. Love that. The loafer, comfortable and sophisticated shoe, great with jeans. The olive camo loafer, fan favorite. And who doesn't love slip-on sneakers? More outsole support. Wear these to the grocery store, the office. My go-to neutral, the gray camo. For more of my favorite styles, visit rothys.com/juliespick.
Don't overdo it today. I know it's pretty when you look out and you see the gorgeous blue skies, a few clouds out there. It's a gorgeous day and you want to step out and enjoy the day, maybe do some work outdoors, but it's hot out there. Sweltering conditions today. Your feels like temperature across the board, mid and upper 90s area wide. We are right there on that 100 degree mark in Myrtle Beach. 100 degree feels like temperatures in Sumter, 96 in Darlington, and 97 in Florence, and it feels like 94 in Bennettsville. You're going to have to do some extra work. It's going to take a little bit more for your body to cool off and manage this type of heat. I know we are about 14 days away from fall. We should be cooling off. It's not happening fast enough. Live Doppler 15,000 is dry, so you're not going to get much relief in the rain department. As we look ahead throughout the afternoon as well as tomorrow, rain chances will come in fairly low. So we'll look at only small rain chances. Tuesday morning, we'll start off a little fog out there early on, so expect a few delays out there for that morning commute. Afternoon time frame, we'll tap into the heating of the day and trigger a few isolated showers out there. But by and large, most of you will avoid that rainfall on your Tuesday. Go ahead and set the timer on the sprinkler. Notice the rain chances are going to be fairly low. We'll stay mainly dry through the middle of the week, and we'll work in better rain chances by the weekend. It's unfortunate that we'll have to deal with the rain on the weekend, but those numbers can certainly change since the weekend is so far away. Now, your forecast for tomorrow afternoon, just like today, high heat and humidity, that combination is going to be at work again tomorrow with those small rain chances, the wind from the east at about 5 to 10 miles per hour. So another quick warm up today, tomorrow, and the next day afternoon, shower and storm chances. Very typical summertime setup day in and day out for this week. Your Grand Strand 10-day forecast, mid-80s each and every day. Little to no chances of rain on Wednesday and Thursday. The same across the PD. Just take note, your mornings will get a little bit cooler by the middle part of this week.
And welcome back. All right, Kind Keepers, this is a no-kill shelter, and they have a lot of pets, and they need your help in adopting them.
That's right, and oh my goodness, they have the sweetest little black lab mix right here. And she has some siblings as well, right, Nancy?
She does. This is Zola.
Oh,
she's about 3 months old, lab mix, and she has a brother and sister also.
Look at that sweet baby. She's about, what, 2 or 3 months old?
3 months old.
Okay. She's wonderful, perfect, ready to be trained,
yes.
Ready for all of that and go to a loving family. Okay, talk about Hurricane, talk about Kind Keeper and what you guys might need right now.
Well, right now, our biggest need is to help us find a dog that got out of a foster home, that escaped this weekend out of a foster home over in the Longs area.
Okay.
We have been looking day and night for her. Her name is Wendy, and she's... could be hiding like under a porch, anywhere. She's not.
Hold it up closer to you. We can show it.
Yeah, let's see. Yeah, hold
just
it up
hold
right,
right
close to your face,
you
and maybe we can get a close, tight
get
shot
a close
of that.
Up shot of it. Okay.
See what she looks like.
She's not aggressive. She's very timid, very shy.
Okay.
What we'd like to put out there, if anybody at all,
there she is, right there.
Right.
Has a drone, because this area here is nothing but woods. Lots of thick woods.
Okay.
And we've been out there morning and night looking, and we would welcome any volunteers who want to come out and help us, or a drone. And it's off of 90 near Bombing Range Road, I believe it is. So if anybody can help us out, we're going to be there at 6 o'clock this evening with a group of volunteers to look. We're heartbroken because she's being fostered, and we really just want her back.
Yes.
And
yes.
Make sure she's safe.
So she's not aggressive. She may be very scared.
She's very, very scared. She is not aggressive, but she will be very timid and very shy.
So best thing to do is kind of keep your eyes on our locator
call
and give you guys a
call. And we will, you know, if we're not already there, and we should be, I'm sure, unless you just happen to see him walk.
Awesome. Good to see you.
Thank you so much.
Bye, thank
puppy.
You.
Oh my goodness gracious. If I
all
could
right,
take
we'll be back.
One.
We got a lot more coming up. Stay with us.
All right, the Grand Strand Buddy Walk is set for Saturday, October 26th. This benefit is to benefit the Down Syndrome Society. We're going to find out how you can get involved and help a really great cause.
That's right. We got Tony and Jeremy with us now. And Tony, let's talk a little bit about the Buddy Walk and about what it's all about.
Okay. It's an event that we're having at Coastal Carolina. It's Saturday, like she said, October 26th, from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. People can register online. I think you're putting the website address on the station. And what we do is we're raising awareness, sharing joy, and bringing hope to children with Down syndrome in Horry County.
Fantastic.
The children have games to play. There's inflatables. We have an award ceremony. We provide free lunch for everybody. And then at the end, we have a walk, and they walk around the campus. I'm looking for volunteers, and I'm also looking for people to help us sponsor the Buddy Walk.
All right.
Last year, we had about 600 people there. This year, I expect it to be larger, because we're having a ribbon cutting before the Buddy Walk from the Chamber of Commerce.
Great.
Well, that's good. Now they can go to that website we had up just a minute ago to find out more about it and how to get in touch
with you. How to register and how to get in contact with us, yes, directly.
All right, Jeremy, you gonna be there, right?
Yes, I am.
All right.
You got
tell
something
us.
You wanna read?
Yes, I do.
All right.
Team GME is doing fundraiser for Full Wave. I have lost 35 pounds this year, and I pledged 10 hours in the GM for each printed dollar donation. I sent out messages on Team GME Facebook page asking for donations for Crazy Fox.
Fantastic.
That's good.
All right, so you already lost 35 pounds. You're going to pledge donations. You're going to pledge time in the gym for people to donate to you. That's awesome. Go lift some weights, right?
Very good.
Fantastic.
Jeremy's part of our Adult 321 group, and they do activities together monthly. And Jeremy has been working for Kroger's now for 23 years.
That is great.
Yeah. Fantastic.
That is great.
Well, thank you guys for being with us. Again, you can check out the website that was right there up on the screen for more information. Again, Saturday, what date?
October 26th from 10 to 3. And I want to thank ABC for having us come on.
Absolutely. All right. Good to see you guys. Stick around. We've got more coming up.
All right, carrying on a Lifetime's here today. Susan's here and JoJo's with them. We're going to talk about a big event coming up next month. And you're going to need to learn all about it because this is a huge event.
It sure is. Of course, October being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, this is, you guys, this is, the fall is your biggest time right now. And of course, you have the, what is the race?
BFF, That's Breast right. Friends Forever, which is held at Barefoot Landing. This is our seventh year. I believe.
Good, we'll go with it.
Yeah, that sounds good. And it's a fun race. You can run, you can walk, you can dress up. We've got all these great medals. And I'm gonna let JoJo tell you a little bit about the race coming up. And these are our nice t-shirts we're gonna have this year. And they're very soft.
They are very soft. I saw them out there.
What's on the back? Anything on the back?
Well, we don't have our logo on the front yet.
So hold it up real still right there. Let everybody see it.
Yeah, hold it right there. That logo, that looks
we're
good.
We're fighters. Yeah.
That's
we're
right.
Fighters. We're winners.
That's right. All right, and all of this supported, of course, by Caring in Our Lifetime. You guys are a nonprofit in the area.
We're a nonprofit. Uh-huh. All our money stays in Orion, Georgetown County to help with medical bills related to breast cancer.
Awesome. JoJo, let's hear about the race.
So we, October 5th, starting at 7:30, we'll start off with our 10K. We will have a 5K and also a 1 mile race. This year new is the challenge. You can run all three and earn a challenge medal. And if you cannot attend that day, you can run virtually.
See, okay, Whoa. We talked about this already. You run, it's the honor system. Yeah. And tell me about that.
Yep, you register online just like everyone else. Race day comes around. If you're not available that day, you can do it the day before, day after. Run the same distance that you registered for, and we will ship your race packet to you.
Now that's pretty cool.
That's very cool. These are neat. Who designed these? Who came up with
this? This is very neat.
Yeah, who came up with those? Those are so nice.
Thank you.
We don't know.
They look good, though.
Yeah, they're great. I kind of want all of them.
I don't run. You can run in all three races and you get that big one.
Exactly.
Cecil. Yeah. I don't run. Anyway, but you can walk. And you can support somebody or honor someone. Mm-hmm. That's the biggest thing about this race.
Yes, this year JoJo tells me they're going to have a memorial. You can buy memorial signs online to post along the run,
okay.
Or in honor of somebody that is a survivor. I'm going to sign myself up.
I love
and,
it.
And
go to the website. Learn more about it.
BFFPinkRibbonRun.com.
Yes.
Thank you both for being with us, girls. Thank you,
Dan. Thanks.
All right, coming up, we're going to talk about a cancer fundraiser and a lot of neat items that you can bid on. We'll be right back.
All right, talking about the Inlet Jam for Cancer Research is a cancer fundraiser set for October 19th right over there at the Beaver Bar. Always doing great things to help this community. Right now we're going to find out more about the event. Come out, have a great time, and donate some funds.
That's right, Harry's with us. Leslie was coming. She told me Saturday she was going to try to come and be with you, but she didn't come. So, Leslie, we missed you.
She had to go to Daytona.
That's right. Go down there. All right, let's talk a little bit about it. Now, this is a cancer fundraiser event, and you've got a lot of autographs. Tell me about the event first. Where's
First of all, it's... It's October the 19th from noon to 5. We're going to have, it's a brainchild of mine and an old friend of mine, Tom Smith, who's the bass player in the Mullets. And we are actually going to have four bands playing. He did all the music. I did all the other stuff.
Cool.
Getting all the donation items together and all the other booking, everything else. Like, well.
Yeah. There's your flyer.
We're going to have the Mullets. We're going to have another great band called Cornbread, which is a local band, a band out of Charleston called New Attitude, which is an old classic rock 70s and 80s music group. And then JK and Friends, which is a group, a reunited group of 60 and 70 year olds that used to play in the college circuit back in the early 70s
That's
in Southeast United States.
Now, we showed a lot of guitars just a minute ago. Now you've got one here, hold it up and show us. Now this is one of them that just showed a few minutes ago. Now who has signed, who's this?
This is Kenny Chesney has signed this. Blue Chair Bay is his official rum.
Yeah.
And the Blue Chair Bay people actually have a letter of authenticity saying they witnessed Kenny Chesney sign this guitar right here.
So that is the
original. It still has the paper around the strings, which is a brand new guitar, never been played. This is one of the items we're going to have.
Wow.
Okay.
It's a great item.
And now, you showed this a minute ago. Tell us about that.
This is a baseball helmet that my friend Gary Gilmore from Coastal Carolina, signed up there. It's got a little spot there that says Gilly, and his number he had at college. He and I went to school together back in the late 70s out there. Plus, I got more stuff coming from Coastal, hopefully this week and the next week.
Great.
We've got a lot of other great items coming. The best thing of this whole thing is that all the proceeds are going to go to the Hollings Cancer Center for cancer research being clinical trials, which a lot of insurance companies and other people cannot or will not pay. And I personally met over the last 4 or 5 years these people. They've gotten these clinical trials and are still living now. It was their last
hope.
And they
you can find out more about this. You can go by to a Beaver Bar, or you can go to what website real quick?
Website. We don't really have a website.
Call us. We'll tell you when it is. It's October the 19th at the Beaver Bar.
Noon to 5. Yes, sir. Right.
You got it. Hey, thanks for being with me,
buddy. Yes, sir. Thank you. Appreciate it. Bye.
All right, stick around. We've got more coming up.
It's funny, it's crazy, and you never know what Cecil or Amanda are going to say or do.
Chewing gum burns about 11 calories.
It's Carolina and Company live weekdays on ABC 15, a fun show that makes you laugh and makes you feel good about where you live. If you just moved to the area, Carolina and Company Live is the show you need to watch. You'll find out about everything going on along the Grand Strand, Feedy, and Border Belt. Check it out weekdays at noon on WPDE ABC 15.
Thank you so much for watching today. It's so good to be back. Last week, the news took us, of course, and did all the coverage of the storm, and the meteorologists did such a super job.
Yeah, really. They really did. I think we might have gotten all of our and our kinks out. What do you think?
I don't know. It'll take me till tomorrow to get it all straight.
You know what we're going to have to do? You guys are going to have to watch the rest of the week right here at noon to see if he messes up. Me too.
Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you back here tomorrow on Tuesday. Another great show.
That's right. Have a wonderful afternoon. Everybody. We'll see you guys later. Have a good one. See ya.